Welcome back to Win at Email Design. I'm so excited about today's email design topic, the newsletter. As always, my main goal here is to help you overcome the fear of starting from scratch and inspire you to design a beautiful email in under 10 minutes. If this is your first time joining us, welcome. I'm Michael Smith, the art director at AWeber. In the last episode, we talked about welcome emails and a simple structure that makes them both visually compelling and emotionally relatable. Design as a discipline is often perceived to be the pretty fonts or colors that are used to decorate and give assets a facelift. However, design is so much more. It's the way you experience something, the way something is built, and then on top of that, the way it looks. When it comes to building a newsletter email, there are a few different ways to look at the design. So before we jump into what that looks like, let's ask the question. What is the purpose of a newsletter email? A newsletter is really just a digest of recent or related content. It could be your content or someone else's, but either way, it's a collection that has some unifying factor. Now, this might shock you, but your readers aren't permanently camped out on your website, refreshing every few minutes to see if you've posted a new article. So a great way to keep readers engaged is to collect their email address and then follow up regularly with newsletters. A newsletter helps remind readers that you exist, and then it gives them relevant new content that you want them to know about. And then, on top of that, you can start building thought leadership on that topic. I want to walk through two options on newsletter design. The first being a very, very basic email example that looks like a personal email you might get from a friend. And then the other one is a more decorative application of a newsletter. I'll be using AWeber templates that come free in every account, but keep in mind that these principles apply to any email provider you choose to use. The steps for the plain newsletter are pretty simple. If you're following along in AWeber, I'm using the default template, and this version is just a text email like you would write in Gmail, but we're going to add links throughout. Often when I use this method, I'll put a double greater than symbol at the end of the link to make it look like an arrow. Here, kind of like this. The biggest hurdle with this email design approach is writing the content, though. But remember, the design intent is to get information to the reader as easily as possible without distractions. So this style's not for everyone. It's not really my thing. But let's look at another variation that uses more visuals. Let's revisit the fake brand, Leaf It To Me, from the first episode. This is what a newsletter from their site might look like. And the template we're using here is the Digest template. This template has drop zones for corresponding images to go along with each post, as well as very clear CTA buttons that help you up that click game. Like we've done before, let's customize this template to make it our own. Add the logo, drop in the brand colors, and then let's pick some images to go with our posts. It's already on its way to being ready to be sent. But similarly to the simpler text-based email, the content is the most challenging part. This email variation makes it even easier to write, though, because all you need to do is write a headline, two-sentence description, and a CTA copy for each post, and then that's sufficient to entice readers to click on the full post. Wow! Would you look at that transformation that happened in just a few clicks? All right, you want to see something really cool, though? Check out these four emails. They're all using the same template. All that has changed is the logos, colors, images. That's why I love this template. It's so versatile. Oh, and did I mention that AWeber uses this for our own blog newsletter? All right, now that I've shown you these two options, there's one bonus newsletter idea that I didn't cover. And that's this idea called a curated newsletter. Let's say you want to build a following, but you're not a writer. In that case, collecting and curating relevant articles might be the right method for you. A great way to do this is with AWeber's Curate app. It allows you to add articles you're reading to a queue, then you can edit them and send them all from your phone. No matter which way you slice it, the newsletter email can be designed in so many different fashions and make you successful. So let's hear from you. What's your biggest newsletter design challenge? Or what have you found to be highly successful in your testing? Why don't you share that with us in the comments below? We'd really appreciate it. As always, thank you for watching. And next time, I can't wait to offer more value about email design. Peace and hugs. Thanks for watching.